Hello everyone, it's Ricardo and I'm still playing Elite Dangerous. Now the purpose of this video today is not to talk about the in-game happenings of Elite Dangerous or show you how to do a passenger run or shoot somebody. It's to talk about the HUD and the HUD colours. Now I play Elite on the PC and there are obviously different versions out. You've got the Mac, you've got the PC, you've got the PlayStation and the Xbox One, Xbox One S and whatever the new one is. Xbox X. Anyway, the Xbox. So, Elite's been on them for quite a while. However, on the consoles, as far as I understand it, you cannot change your HUD colour. Sorry, console users, you're stuck with the orange. Now that's as of the 14th of January 2018. We're all waiting for Beyond to come and hit us in beta on the 25th of January. However, at this point in the game, we haven't been given any indication that in the consoles you'll be able to change your HUD color. So sorry about that everyone. Anyway, if you do play on the PC and you feel a break from the norm and you're sick of that orange, okay, you can change your HUD colors. Now I'm using this HUD configuration. So the cyan is so light it's nearly a white, a little blue tint to it, and also we've got the red around some of the accents as well. The station and the ship show up as green, and we flick through. I think it's nice and bright. I think it's nice and, you know, it's fresh looking as opposed to the dreary orange that you get as standard. Now all this is all well and good, but what's the numbers and how do I do it, right? Well, I'll show you what the numbers are. Now don't worry, I'll put them up at the end and I'll also put them in the comments of the video as well so you can see them. But how do you apply it? So let's take a look at that. Now if you haven't already done so, please click that subscribe and like button. That'll really help me out, and look for the notification icon as well, as that'll let you know when I'm putting more videos like this on YouTube. Now there's a few old different ways you can change your HUD. You've got the Elite Dangerous Profiler by Dr. Kai. Now this is a great little tool, as it will allow you to view in the HUD editor what colors you want. You can simply change these out in any of the color bands and get colors that's good for you. This is great. Once you've got the numbers, you can stick it back into here and apply, and bang, there it is. Okay. You can detect your current settings, which is showing my current HUD settings here. So there's one way. Deep Dangerous Profiler by Dr. Kai. He's got instructions on his website. I think it's a fantastic tool. Please get out there and support him. You know, I don't think you can go far wrong. If you want to do it manually, then you're going to have to navigate to the App Data, Local, Frontier Development, Elite Dangerous, Options and Graphics folder. That's a bit of a mouthful, isn't it? Now generally you might not be able to see this, so what you'll have to do within File Explorer is turn on Hidden Items, and then I've also got File Extensions turned on as well. The only reason for that is that some of the files and folders within Windows 10 and other versions of Windows are hidden from the general public, and they do that to stop you doing anything ridiculous like deleting them. So be very careful on what you're doing, okay? I take no responsibility for anyone breaking their computers or their system configuration. Now, the file you want is the GraphicsConfiguration.xml. If you right-click that and say Open With, and then click on Notepad, you'll open the file. And that is basically all that's in mine. Now, the numbers that you want are these. Paste them in, and then you can have HUD colors just like mine. Save the file into Elite, load it up, and then you can have a HUD just like that one down in the little window. Also, there are other sites. ARKKU.com HUD editor. Again, here you can test out what the HUD looks like, and it gives you a little box down the bottom that you can cut and paste and then post it into your graphics configuration override.xml file. So you can go full on lemon. You can change different aspects. You can really have a good play about with it. Anyway, lots of instructions there as well. Also, it gives you some information on where to look for things. Hidden directories, as we mentioned, app data, local windows, wherever you know you've got your local windows folder, whether that be C, D, E, whatever, G, who knows? Who knows where you put it? And there's also support there for macOS. Okay, so it's the graphics configuration XML. There you go, see, lovely graphics override. Post that in there, and you're a good one. You're all done. And then you can have a HUD just like this. So there's a few ways of doing it. I do it my way. There's the ED profiler way. There's the website I just showed you. So hopefully you can now go around and start rocking some great HUD colors. Be very careful how you do it. Thanks very much for watching. I'll put the HUD colors in a big text file at the end, and I'll put them in the comment section as well. And happy tinkering. Fly safe. Look out for more videos in the series.